Hey everybody, welcome to the Imprint Series Volume 3, which is our penultimate concert of the year. We have one more still to come in a couple weeks that will be the premiere of all the pieces that you wrote for the chamber music collaboration, so that's very exciting. Stay tuned for that. Also, we have a heftier concert tonight, but also Alfredo very helpfully built in a little intermission, so you'll have some time to get up and stretch your legs, refill your drinks, and be nice and comfy. Also, since there won't be an audio intro to the final concert, I really wanted to take a very, very quick moment to say thank you all for an incredibly supportive and positive and collaborative and amazing year. It's been a huge blast to get to know so many of you through this series. I also wanted to say thank you to everyone on the Imprint team, to Ryan and Hannah and Yanchen and Zan and Gala and Alfredo, especially Alfredo, because of all of the incredible work he's done on all of these videos and presentations. So please extend all of your love and appreciation to all those folks. Please enjoy the concert, and let's finish up the semester strong.
In Full Bloom for Bass Clarinet, Fixed Media, and Electronics was written for Ford Fairquin last summer. Last summer, as we all probably were, I spent a lot of my time outdoors. Whether or not I'd be on long walks around my neighborhood with my dogs, or sitting on my patio for the pure enjoyment of just being outside. I began to notice a lot more of this daily neighborhood walks from March until July. Flowers and weeds that would seem to perk up at the sight of the sun, new animals and new squirrels all around, which trees bloomed leaves and which ones didn't. The way that the wind even felt in some areas of my neighborhood felt different to me. I wanted to capture the blooming that I noticed much more closely this past year from spring to summer in this piece. This being my first piece for electronics and fixed media, I chose to incorporate something that felt familiar and freeing to me by recording my own voice. Ford is an absolutely wonderful person, collaborator, and friend, and I'm so happy to have worked with him to make this piece.
Thank you. There seems to be a irredeemability to the sins committed in the poem, that violence. The narrator obviously beckons to the moon to clear, you know, the scene, to sort of bathe it, to purify it. But that isn't possible. And part of the music is trying to describe that sense of hopelessness and sense of overwhelming, unforgiven guilt.
Matchstick for Reed Quintet tells the story of all the power held in a single small match. From the spark that springs forth when it's lit, the frenzy as it burns itself out, the wispy tendrils of smoke that pervade the darkness once it's extinguished, and the spread from that single flame, beginning with a deceptively simple mischievous flickering, giving way to the raw power that demonstrates the light, hope, energy, and destruction that can be fueled by even the smallest source. I'm so grateful for the incredible musicians for their work in bringing this piece to life. Megan Wojtyla on oboe, Asher Harris on clarinet, Salvador Flores on alto saxophone, Aaron Brown on bassoon, and Nathaniel Farrar on bass clarinet. Thank you all, and I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Hi, my name is Grayson. Last year this time, when what is now the new reality was starting to reveal itself, live music would be going away for some time, which is something that we learned quite quickly on. So I had this moment where I was like, well, I'm not going to write live music because there's no purpose in it. It's not happening. So I fell back on one of my other loves in music, which was synthesizers, buttons and knobs, processing, electronics. So because of this, one day I asked myself the question, can I make music that I'm excited about, and most importantly, excited about sharing with others, with just what I have at my immediate disposal? What about the sound of the clatter of ice and a glass of sweet tea? Is there something there to be used? Or the sound of the fanning pages of a book? Is there something musically stable within that, something that can stand on its own two feet? The result of this adventure was an album called Be in Peace. It's 7 tunes, and what you're about to hear are 3 of those tunes. So if you like what you hear this evening and you want to listen to the rest of the music, it was just released. So you can go to Spotify, Apple Music, Bandcamp, or really anywhere you listen to music. Type in my name, Grayson Jarvis, or type in Be in Peace, and you can listen to it. So again, thank you for listening, and I hope you enjoy 3 from Be in Peace.
Oh. In March of 2020, I started to feel homesick for the first time ever. I'm from a small town in Texas, and when I left at age 18, I began to define myself by the cosmopolitanism and scholasticism of the places to which I moved: Los Angeles, New Haven, and eventually Ann Arbor. However, when the pandemic started, I missed home because we didn't know when we would ever be able to go back. To cope with this, I started listening to country songs that I hadn't heard since my youth, and to my surprise, I found that I remembered them quite well. One of those songs was "Born to Fly" by Sarah Evans, and a particular line got stuck in my head on repeat. It sounds like this. And how do you keep your feet on the ground when you know? The full lyric is, "How do you keep your feet on the ground when you know you were born to fly?" which seemed to encapsulate so many of my feelings. So with this cello piece, I wanted to create a sort of fantasia on memory using the rising scale snippet I just played, and I wanted to make music that desires to escape its origins while also being nostalgic for them. Many thanks to the incredible Ashley Bathgate for recording it, and I hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
Navigating Through depicts the journey of an artist during our current world situation. For me as a composer, it highlights the array of emotions that I have experienced in trying to adapt to the world in its current state. It all seems to end with the overwhelming feeling of isolation and a desperate attempt to cling on to some sense of normalcy. Natural sounds are provided by the National Park Service.
Thank you. Talking Points is my second piece centered on the topic of political discourse. It was written just after the disastrous first presidential debate on September 29th, 2020, and much of the material for the accompanying fixed media tracks is sourced from that event. The piece was written for the University of Michigan Concert Band under the direction of Dr. Courtney Snyder, and features one of each instrument in that ensemble, plus harp and percussion. In our modern political discourse, we are constantly being fed carefully crafted talking points through social media, radio, and television. We hear them over and over again, with only slight variations each time. For me, this awareness comes with a desire to cut through the noise and think for myself, rather than let the talking points do the thinking for me.
Mima'a Makim for solo soprano and fixed media electronics was composed in 2019 on commission from soprano Annika Kildegard. The spectacular soprano you'll be hearing premiere the work tonight. Mima'a Makim Kiraticha Havaya. Havaya Shim'a Vekoli Tiena Oznecha Kashuvot Lekol Tachanunai. Im Avonot Tishmorya Havaya Mi Ya'amod. Kiviti Havaya Kifta Nafshi Velidvaro Hochalti. Nafshi Lavaya Mishomrim Laboker Shomrim Laboker. From the depths I call to you, great existence. Great existence, hear my voice. Let your ears be attentive to my cry for mercy. If you kept a record of our sins, great existence, who would stand? I wait for the great existence, my whole being waits, and in their word do I hope. My soul waits for the great existence, more than watchmen for the morning, watchmen for the morning.
Mima Amakim.